Sometimes we forget why we're here. It's easy to fall off track. These help us remember.
These battle scars don't look like the fate.
A dream, something no one else could see. Tell me what it means when your faith is falling beneath your knees and you can't breathe. Everything you see reminds you of what you're not or something you won't be. You gotta take what you're given, that's how we live it. Don't be mad at the system, it's simply how we've existed. I hear a lot of people talking like they politicians and choose to be an accountant because it's safe in a business. Not because they wanna do it, just because they heard it pays. And who the fuck wants to be poor, knowing that's how we've been raised. Society is getting heavy, I can feel the weight. The pressure of success is like 100 million pounds of shame. And that's the reason I'm staying up late, trying to find a way to escape the stereotypes. This day and age is making me feel like the only way I'll be happy is getting signed to a label and making money through rapping. I wanna share my emotion because this world is attacking the very principle of life that lets the people be happy. If you don't have a reason to breathe, why even live? These battle scars are impressions of everything that it is.
Hello and welcome to the first season 13 FGL Match of Day. My name is the Big Boss Man Yadi, and as you all know, is the Big Boss Man Dambo. So first up, we will start with the BPL, and the first team is the mighty big badass LFC Liverpool. So Mr. G has assembled quite the team this season. It's because he's got me up front. Anyway, with 3 wins, 1 loss and drawing 2. They are currently sitting in 4th place with 11 points, which is a massive improvement on myself as a manager. So well done there, Mr. G. Hopefully, we can finally get our hands on some important trophies. That's the plan, and I know all the boys are up for it, so bring it on. Anyway, we're going to show you a clip now, so over to the clips, big boy.
You were the shadow to my light. Did you feel us? Another star, you fade away. Afraid our aim is out of sight. Wanna see us alive.
And Abraham.
Where are you now?
Have it, big ass mighty Liverpool smashing it up for you.
Yeah, right. Here we go then. Next up, we got Cardiff City, and they've had a good start to the season, sitting in 6th place, also on 11 points. However, Cardiff are now under new management, but they're still going strong, with Badazi scoring 6 and assisting 1 on their first night. So congratulations to you, and here's your clip.
Okay, so there you have it. There's Cardiff's Cliff. So now over to the penultimate team in the BPL, which is Southampton. Having a poor start to the season, currently sitting in 11th place on 3 points. Due to teams refusing to pay, basically being knobs, they are now under new management. Hopefully now they will start gaining themselves some much needed points. Good luck when you play Liverpool. Oh, yeah!
Oh, good luck. That was that. Finally, in the BPL, we've got QPR. The manager from the last few seasons, DJ Nixon's decided to stay with his team to try and win that all-important BPL trophy, sitting so far in third place on 12 points with 4 wins and 2 losses. If QPR keep playing well, they'll definitely be a contender for some silverware. So here you are.
It isn't much, but it's enough to make me wonder what's in store for us. It's lust, it's torturous. You must be a sorceress, cause you just did the impossible. Gain my trust. Don't play games, it'll be dangerous. You fuck me over, cause if I get burnt, I'ma show you what it's like to hurt. Cause I've been treated like dirt, before you, and love is evil. Spell it backwards, I'll show you.
Okay then, so over to the BPL table. In first place currently we have Derby County with 16 points. In second place we have Manchester City with 14. In third place we have QPR with 12. And in fourth we have the big mighty Liverpool with 11. Fifth we have West Ham with 11. And sixth we have Cardiff City with 11. So all fighting there. Moving on to seventh place we have Leicester City with 7 points. In 8th, Manchester City United with 6 points. Shit cheating Robin Kurtz offside. In 9th place, we have Hull City with 5 points. In 10th, we have Newcastle United with 3 points. In 11th, Southampton with 3. And in Rockstone Bottom, we have the mighty Everton with 3 points. So next up, we have the championship for you. And the first team we have is Arsenal. Under the leadership of the ever-present Frankie Fraser, the player has had a steady start to the season, currently sitting in fourth place on 10 points, with 3 wins, losing 2 and drawing 1. Considering the strength of the squad, they will be hoping to be more consistent to make a push to the top of the season. Continues. Right, as the season continues. Moving on. Over to your clips. Let's watch this.
Well done, Arsenal. Right, over to, looks like it's Leeds. So Leeds have been having a slow start to the season, sitting in 10th place on 5 points. Now under new management, they'll be looking to get up the table and make it into a Europa League spot. So here's Leeds.
Okay, well, that was an interesting conversation there about how hot I am. Thanks, boys. So up next, we have the boys in orange. Yeah, you're not red like me, bruv. We have Wolves. Wolves are having a disappointing start to the season, sitting in 9th place on 6 points, winning 2 and losing 4. Hopefully now they have expanded their team. The new players can add a bit of magic and a bit of spark to the team. So here's a clip. So
now I could write something that's ignorant, presented as immaculate, then package it for people to purchase, digging inside your purses and pockets for profit that I know that you need it. Don't pay your mortgage or no car, don't give them dollars to me. I dominantly attest the system that was set in place with politics. The problem is this shit is archaic, so I'll explain it quick. Of course you need a singular image, then you're excelling. Don't worry about your content, cause hatred is always relevant and prevalent. I'm sure you'll find the proper way to sell the kids and catch them while they're young. They never question your integrity, selectively invaded the market. Your product's average and with money behind it, I promise that you'll be popping up. Put you on every blog and that's how you gain your respect. When you popular, they assuming you're automatically next. And your catalog filled with records that sound exactly the same. It's insane and fucking monotonous. All your music is draining the energy out my body. It's crazy, I'm trying to take it back to pocket bigger punters. I punish you with these artifacts, relics of what they used to be. Honesty over you, so retake a seat, come and see, I believe.
There we are then. Lastly in the championship, we've got Birmingham City. It's been a poor start to the season, sitting in 11th place. Losing 5 and drawing 1, giving them 1 point, which places them above bottom. But they only have a slightly better goal difference. Vav is Birmingham's key player, scoring 2 with 30 tackles. Hopefully they'll be better as a unit over the rest of the season and get them some much needed points. So here is Birmingham City.
You have a story about a mouse named Lori. Your Lori was a mouse in the big round house. She calls the tuffy hole. That little mouse, cause I'm an albatross. I'm an albatross. I'm an albatross. Your Lori said she was a mouse, smoked the cheese and liked the towel. Money, 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 oh, chinga, chinga, chinga. Damn, Lori was a witch, make a little switch. That little mouse, cause I'm an albatross. I'm an albatross. I'm an albatross.
us.
Okay, we're moving over to the championship table. In first place, we have Crystal Palace sitting on 18 points. In second, we've got Ipswich sitting on 15. In third, we have Chelsea on 13 points. In fourth, we got Arsenal with 10. In fifth, we also have Middlesbrough sat on 10 points. In sixth place, we have Brighton with 9. In seventh, we got Burnley with 8. In eighth, we got Sheffield Wednesday with 7 points. In ninth, we got Wolves with 6 points. In tenth, we got Leeds United with 5 points. And 11th, we got Birmingham City with 1 point. And Rock Stone Cold Bottom, they need to find Gareth Bale, is Tottenham Hotspurs with 1 point. Okay, moving on. So that's it all for the English. And now we're going to move over to the Spanish League, starting with the BBVA. And the first team we're going to talk about this week is Atletico Madrid. Atletico Madrid haven't had the start they would have hoped for, with only 2 wins all season and conceding 9 goals. QFI Reese has been their star man this season with 3 goals in 6 games this season. They need to improve if they want to get Champions League this season. So lads, pick your ball up, start passing it around, use the A ball, less of the Y ball. Jobs are fucking good, and over to you, Cliff.
On the door when the night begins. Cause we've done this before, so you come on in. Make yourself at my home, tell me where you been. Pour yourself something cold, baby, cheers to this. Sometimes you gotta stay in, and you know where I live. Yeah, you know what we is. Sometimes you gotta stay in, and you know where I live. Yeah, you know what we is. Sometimes you gotta stay. Welcome to the top, baby, take control now. We can't even slow down, we don't have to go out. Welcome to my house, play that music too now. Show me what you do now, we don't have to go out. Welcome to my house. Welcome to my house. Close the blinds, let's pretend that the time has changed. Keep our clothes on the floor, open up champagne. Let's continue tonight, come on, celebrate. That's how we do it, you gotta stay.
Have it right. Next up, we've got Ouch in second in the BBVA with 14 points this season. They're challenging for the title this season, and they are still in for a chance to win the title. MLGX Callum would be happy with his team and top goal scorer Alvaro Morata. 9 has definitely helped them get into second. So, here are
you
their clips.
So the third team this week we have in the BBVA is Real Oviedo. Real Oviedo are sitting mid-table in the BBVA. I know Killer's going to kill me in a minute. We have 10 points this season. They have 3 wins and 2 losses this season. They have only scored 4 this whole season. Mate, I scored that on my own, bro. Yeah? So, manager Fox, you need to pick your team up, bro. And so am I, mate. Get them to improve and get them to start challenging for that top 4 spot. Anyway, over to your clip, my dad.
Mesdames et messieurs, s'il vous plaît, soyez prêts pour Aaron Chupa et Apatraoz. C'est parti.
I got it.
Was Real Oviedo. Right, next up we've got Levant. Levant aren't having the best season. They're only having 4 points, conceding whopping 15 goals already.
Wow.
New manager, XX Man United.
It's good when they go Man United, bro. You all shit, mate.
Is managing Levant.
Why didn't you just play some offside, mate? Whip him in the box, mate. Get some goals, bro. That's what Man United do. Real life cheating bastards.
Fuck off. No, they don't. Man United played well today.
Fucking cheating cats.
But anyway, so the manager will maybe bring some fresh faces.
Fucking Man United, bunch of bastards.
It's only the first week of the season. So don't worry. Rubbish. You might have a bit of time.
It's the attacking third. Up to me. Wonderful finish. I think this season. And here's the cross. Goes for goal with a header. Oh, he put it into his own net.
Don't you ever say I just walk away. I will always walk.
Side able to dwell on the ball for very long here.
Running for my life. I will always walk.
Well defended. Just getting across. Thought quickly as well.
Sorry about the delay. It was abusing Easy Killer.
Right, over to the table then. Over to the BBVA table. Okay, so the BBVA table stands like this. In first place, we have Atletico Bilbao.
Bilbao.
Bilbao with 15
Bilbao,
points.
Bilbao, I think it's called.
Yeah. Now, in second, we have Auchi. Yeah, with 14 points. In third, we had Granada. Yeah, used to be on the telly then, bad boys. 13 points. Fourth, we have Real Madrid. I can pronounce your name properly. You have 12 points. Red over though. You got 10. Sat in fifth. In sixth place, we have Sevilla with 9. Seventh, we have Atletico Madrid with 8. Eighth, we have Deportivo with 7. Ninth, we have Barca with 6 points. 10th, Osasuna with 4. 11th, Levant, or whatever you want to call them, with 4. And then rock bottom with 0 points, you shit cunts, is Celta Vigo. Okay, moving on. So, moving on now to the final league of the night, the Atalanta. And first up is Villarreal. Villarreal are sitting in 7th place in the table with 3 wins, 2 losses. Conceding only 6 this season, but only scoring 7 this season. Manager Joe IM98 would want to improve their scoring record this season so his team can challenge for Champions League. Okay, boys, over to Eclipse.
Just like this.
Second team in the Atalanta this week is Rayo Vallecano. Rayo Vallecano have improved a lot since the appointment of new manager Type Cheetah 13. They're sitting in fourth this season, challenging for top two. Vallecano have won 3 and lost 1 this season with a plus 4 goal difference. So here's your clips. Sorry, I ain't got-
Finally, we have the final team, and the final team is Las Palmas.
No, 1-0.
Oh, sorry. No, we're not. Ah, tell a lie. Bullshit. You already talk shit. Right, okay. So next team up is Real Zaragoza. Real Zaragoza are sat in second, with winning 3 and losing 0. They are in contention for the title with Real Sociedad only 1 point ahead, With manager Gaston DX getting 9 goals this season, pushing the team to the potential title. Time will tell. Over to your clips, bro.
Yeah, baby girl, you're so damn fine, though. Wanna know if I can hit it from behind, though. I'm sipping on you like some fine wine, though. When it's over, I press rewind, though. Talking bands, I got it. Benjamins in my pocket. I traded in my truth for some Robins, and he's playing Batman, Fatty's gonna rob him. Yeah, I got the Glock in my robin. 17 shots, no 38. Yeah, I got the Glock in my robin. 17 shots, no 38. Yeah, she's fine. Wondering will she be mine? Walk past, I press rewind. See that ass one more time. And I got this soda. Remy boys, they know it. Fast money, no slow. No one can control it. Yeah. And I got this soda. Remy boys, they know it. Hey. Fast money, no slow. No one can control it.
There we have it. Right. Thanks.
Right, finally,
we have the final team in the Adelante. Las Palmas. And Las Palmas have had an okay season so far with them sitting in fifth. Winning 3, losing 2. They've scored 10 and conceded 7 this season, giving themselves a +3 goal difference. So let's see how good they really play.
Yeah. Baby, girl, you...
Wow.
Well, that didn't work. I don't know why that didn't work. That's because I didn't hear it. Here it is.
Okay, right. Well, as soon as Dan gets himself in gear, right, we're going to go over to the BBVA 2 table. So, okay, in first, we have Real Sociedad sitting with 13 points. In second, we have Real Zaragoza with 12. Third, we have Getafe with 12. Fourth, we have Real Vallecano with 11 points. In fifth, we have Las Palmas with 10. In sixth, Real Betis with 10. Seventh, Villarreal with 10. Eighth, Valencia with 9 points. In 9th place, Espanyol with 8. In 10th, we have Eibar with 4. 11th, we have Sporting Gijon with 1. And rock bottom with 0 points. Kick yourself up the ass, Malaga. Okay, moving on. Next up, we have the much anticipated team of the weeks. And first up, we have the English tops for you, which is as follows. Okay, in goalkeeper, we have X14 Onyedzi for Ipswich Town. In right back, we have Double 9X for Man City. In centre back, we have Spoonzy for Burnley. Left centre back, we have NXOK for Sheffield Wednesday. Left back, we have DMAC for Manchester City. In CDM this week, we have Derby's player TRLX Shawzy. Right centre mid, we have Man City player Sed Wilson. Left centre mid, we have Newcastle United is Emma. In Cannes, we have Derby City's Gafford Wiltshire. Right striker, we have West Ham United's Jack B. Miller 8. Shit, cunt. In left striker, we have Burnley King Drogba. Okay, Water Boys this week. In goalkeeper, we have Leicester City's Jip Islop 15. James Islop 15 or Jimbo. Or
Jimbo Islop.
Right, in left centre back, we have Extreme Origins from Man City. Left back, we have our big main manager, Mr. G for Liverpool. CDM this week is Chelsea's Kev. Kev, you're mad. Okay, in left DM, we have Manchester United's Oi Magic's Oi 6, Oi with the magic. In can we have our big main man, the main man, Buffman, formerly now known as Hart 96X for Liverpool. In left striker this week, we have Crystal Palace Sky Blue Dini, who's a new member, which I was told to be aware of. Okay, so next up is the Spanish, and Dan's going to run you through them.
Wow, I think everyone's tuning in for the team of the week.
Yeah, it seems that way.
Hello, everybody, and on to the Spanish. In goal, we got ITFC Giza for Espanyol. Left back, we've got Herman Sen 90 for Real Zaragoza. Centre back, X Jackal 99 for Valencia. In centre back, also Ryan 6 for Granada. Right back, Miguel Velosa. I know that name from somewhere. Real Madrid. Bren Reed in CDM for Granada. Centre mid, Philly Boy for Real Zaragoza. Centre mid, MUFC Scott for Real Oviedo. In CAM, we got Skills X Tiger for Real Madrid. Striker, Gaston DK, the real baller. Gaston playing for Zaragoza and the real baller playing for Real Madrid. And onto the Water Boys. Badman's Bro in goal for Valencia. Luis de Castro in left centre-back for Real Madrid. James D37 MUFC for Real Sociedad. Brinks B for Real Zaragoza. Fuck me. DB Neville in RDM for Real Vallecano. I Salvate as an any for Real Madrid. And Luke 444 is an any for Real Vallecano.
Okay, and finally, we have the first late league team of the week for you. So, starting in goalkeeper, we have DNL Havalic or some bullshit like that. He plays for Moscow Boys. In right back, we have Miguel Bessoso for Ajax or whatever your fucking name is. Right centre back, Prodigy, whatever your fucking name is, FC Porto. Left centre back, we have the Real Grim One. Left back, we have Ryan Six. DM, we have C's Kubi 3, something like that. DM, we have Crispo. DM, we have Double 9. In CAM, we have Luis de Castro. In right striker, we have DB Ibrahimovic. So big man Pete there from River Plate. Oh, River Plate, which is folded, by the way. Okay, and left striker, we have Holland I 87 I for Boca Juniors. Okay, bench boys this week. In goalkeeper, we have Master Dali 12. Centre back, big main man himself, Frankie Fraser 81. Centre back, we have Dean 1999. DM, we have Cavalier. CM, we have Official Owen. In CAM, we have David Ross 101. And in striker, we have BIF I Pogwerk. Okay, that's, and then we're going to show you the late night league table quickly. So Dan's going to read you through this.
Right, Fenerbahce are on 15 points. PSG are on 15 points. Ajax or Ajax, however people want to say it, 13 points. Lyon on 13 points.
Lyon.
No, it's Lyon.
It's Lyon.
There's a Y. It's not L-E. It's
Lyon.
L-Y.
Lyon.
LA Galaxy on 12. CSKA Moscow on 10. Boca Juniors on 9. Zenit Petersburg on 8. FC Porto on 7. Celtic on 7. Rangers on 7. River Plate on 6.
River Plate!
Can they fold?
Yeah, they folded.
They Galatasaray on 6. PSV Eindhoven on 5. Sao Paulo on 3. And Seattle Sounders on 1.
Right.
So we got a little announcement.
Okay, so over to just our little chat about what's cracking on and all the rest of it. So we got the 11v11 league starting on the 27th, ran by Kaiser. I hope you don't mind VFA, Will.
Is that all right, Will? Yeah. Sure, I'll get a message.
Also, we've got a world ranking club, 7th in the world, competing in that league. Not going to tell you who that is. You can figure it out yourself. Okay, so I'd like to thank everybody and say any important things. I haven't really got anything else really to say, but, you know, I hope you're enjoying FGL. Just watch out for the changes. We've got a few changes happening, coming in. Obviously, Late Night League, we just started. We've got, obviously, the 11v11 League, which, like I say, if you're interested in that, speak to Kaiser. And, obviously, we've got the World Cup thing, which is up on the website, which I know a few of you have asked about, which will all be revealed in due course. So you have to just wait for that.
Lucas, if you're, how do I get to the player area? Click player area when we're not streaming. Also, what a premium shoutbox button has been fixed. It don't go to rules anymore. Is that it?
And I think that's it, really. Yeah. Peace out. Anyway, show the outro.
Oh, Yardie, if you need a replacement for Dambo, give him a shout. All right?
Who's this?
Don't know.
Come on, no boy, idea. Talk more.
Come on.
Dambo's here.
You're going to fucking have me job, mate. I'd love it. Come on. Right, here's the outro, and then Lucas can accept his contract.
I met you in the dark. You lit me up. You made me feel as though I wasn't home. We danced the night away. We drank too much. I held your hair back when you were throwing up. Then you smiled over your shoulder. For a minute I was stone cold sober. I pulled you closer to my chest, and you asked me to stay over. I said I already told you. I think that you should get some rest. Yeah,